Hey, Math 31, I had a request to do number 45. So we have an absolute value equation to solve. And if you remember from this section, if you have your absolute value isolated, if you have something like the absolute value of x is equal to k, then you can write two equations. You can say x is equal to k or x is equal to negative k. And this one's simpler, obviously, than the one you have in front of you in number 45, but the basic idea is whatever is inside of these grouping symbols, these absolute value signs, the bars, you let that equal the number on the right side of your equation, and you let it be equal to the opposite of the number on the right side of the equation. But again, one of the key things is that this absolute value term has to be isolated. And if you look at our absolute value term, it is isolated on the left side of the equation. And if you're wondering what I mean by isolated, what I'm trying to say is it's not like there's a 2 out here and I would need to divide both sides by 2. Or it's not like on the left side of the equation I have a plus 4 and I would need to move the 4 over. So this term here, this absolute value term on the left side of the equation is totally isolated. So what we're going to do is we're going to take what's inside that grouping symbol, right? We're going to set it equal to the number on the right side of the equation and the number, or I should say the opposite of the number on the right side of the equation. So you see me setting it equal to 12 and then negative 12. And when we do that, now we have two quadratic equations. And we need to solve both of them. All right, and we've talked about the three methods for solving a quadratic equation. We can factor, right? We can use the quadratic formula, or we can complete the square. And I've mentioned in a few videos now that my favorite version, if I can, I'm going to factor. If I can't factor, I'm going to use the quadratic formula, and then I usually put off completing the square. Is just, I don't really want to do it. And the cool thing is, again, both of these two methods, they always work. So I actually am pretty good at avoiding completing the square because the quadratic formula will always work. But if we look at our two equations as of right now, I'm going to write them over here. I have x squared plus 2x minus 36 equals 12, or x squared plus 2x minus 36 equals negative 12. And since I'm going to try and factor them, I'm going to set them equal to 0. So I will get x squared plus 2x minus 48 is equal to 0, or x squared plus 2x minus 24 is equal to 0. And it turns out I actually can factor both of those. This becomes x plus 8 times x minus 6. This becomes x plus 6 times x minus 4. And so you see that I'm getting a whole bunch of answers. I'm going to use the zero product property, set each of my factors to 0. So I have x plus 8 equals 0, x minus 6 equals 0, x plus 6 equals 0, and x minus 4 equals 0. And that's where I'm coming up with these four numbers. All right, so there's number 45. Thanks so much, gang. Bye.